Hello, my name is Jean-Luc Pilet. I am a clinical psychologist and lecturer. I come from France, and more precisely from Nantes, the city where the last Congress was held. My action research deals with the improvement of temporal competency with young adults. Now, I will share my screen with you. Okay. In my presentation, there are three parts: the population studied, the first research, and the second one. I'd like to briefly present the population studied. In the table, the young adults are apprentices, former high school dropouts, unqualified, and jobless. The reintegration training led by local public authorities. Trainees are volunteers, 6-month course, and 50% of trainees find a job after the course. In the table, you can see several data: number, average age, and proportion male-female. The first research hypothesis: youth with integrative difficulty have fewer temporal competencies than students. The question we pose: do they have particular difficulty for the past, the present, or the future? We use two time questionnaires: the Zimbardo Time Perspective Inventory with 5 subscales, and the Temporal Competency Test 5D, also with 5 subscales. During this short presentation, I cannot present in detail all the statistical results. They will be published in the future article. Here is a summary of the results. The 3 subscales studying the past are all statistically different. The trainees project themselves less into the past. Furthermore, the memories of the past are negative, and they struggle to rely on the positive past. For the present, there are 3 out of 4 scales are different. The trainees have a significantly different perception of the present. They take advantage of present time, but they are pessimistic about the effectiveness of their actions. They also have a low ability to stay focused. For the future, only 1 out of 3 subscales are different. The trainees have a perception of the future quite close to the students, but they have a much more uncertain perception of the future. Here is the protocol of the second research. We have an experimental group and a control group. In this is 2 groups. At the beginning and at the end of the training, the apprentices complete the same time questionnaires. In the experimental group, we organize a specific action, yellow background in this table. It should be noted that the apprentices are only present at the training center for 3 months. During the other periods, they are in companies. So, planning 4 sessions to work on time management is not easy. I'd like to make several clarifications. The support sheet led by trainer is to define objectives and prioritize action to anticipate obstacles and resources. The first two technical sessions led by psychologic involve revolving of the support sheets, use of therapeutic cohorts, and the last two technical sessions involve preparation of toolbox and assessment of the sessions. Here is the hypothesis of the second research. Trainees in the experimental group will have progressed more than those in the control group, at least three subscale of time questionnaires. Now, the results. Three subscales are different. Uncertain function, fatalistic present, and anticipation. The young adults of the experimental group have a more optimistic vision of their future. Scores of uncertain function and fatalistic present have dropped significantly. At the same time, their anticipatory capacities have increased. As expected, the technical support causes positive effects. But we see that the past negative and temporal rupture scores do not change. It's a COVID influence. In this research, there are limits. Small number of apprentices in experimental group, more than four technical sessions would be preferable. And the project for the next year to extend the time reinforcement protocol to include all the apprentices. Which bring me to my conclusion. For the majority of the apprentices, it's possible to improve their temporal abilities. Young adults appreciate this time training, fortunately. The two time questionnaire used, ZTPI and TCT5D, are very complementary. Thanks for your attention. At the bottom of the slide, you have my email address.